presents the co-featured bout of the evening, 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant WBO Junior Lightweight Intercontinental Championship. So let's get this party started! Fighting out of the blue corner, wearing red, official weight, 129, 3/4 pounds. His professional record, 19 fights, 19 victories, including 16 knockouts. From Cincinnati, Ohio, USA, the number one ranked contender and current NABO champion, the undefeated Adrian the Problem Browner. Fighting out of the red corner, wearing white and red, officially weighing in at 128, 1/4 pounds. 43 professional fights, 41 victories, including 34 knockouts with only 2 defeats. From Cuauhtemoc, Chihuahua, Mexico, former WBO junior featherweight champion of the world, Daniel Potsy.
Mira, aquí está bien. Right here. Right here is good. This is like a man's touch gloves. God bless.
Adrian Broner, the problem, one of the best nicknames in sports right now. But at the moment, is just a big talking, fast southpaw prospect. And tonight we find out if maybe he's something more than just that.
Against Daniel Ponce de Leon, who made 6 successful defenses of his junior featherweight championship before losing that belt to Juan Manuel Lopez in 2007.
Broner's a right-hander, so yeah. Look at that.
I've seen him fight both ways.
Yeah, he fights both ways, but he's starting out right-handed tonight.
Ponce de Leon said, I might have to feel him out for about 2 or 3 rounds and get a feel for the kid. Obviously, Ponce de Leon, much tougher fights in his career, which began in 2001. 200 professional rounds in the ring. Broner has 60. But Broner has the advantage in size. Even Ponce de Leon told us during our fighter meeting yesterday, he's much more comfortable at 126.
That's not usually a good thing to hear when a guy's fighting 130.
Ponce de Leon trying to punch off the ropes. Broner's just brimming with confidence. In fact, when we asked about being on this big stage in this co-feature on Boxing After Dark and how he sort of is going to temper his emotions, he said, well, same way that you guys need to temper your emotions in meeting me.
Well, it's a step up for him, and he does have to be a little careful because those are 8-ounce gloves, if I'm correct. And in 8-ounce gloves, a lot of different things can happen. So, but I think he's all right in this one.
Broner throws a counter right hand.
He said something else very interesting in the fighter meeting. He said when he looked at tapes of Ponce de Leon, he said, is this how he fights? Is this how he fights for real? I mean, as though he's going to walk right through him. So we're going to see if that's going to happen tonight.
You know, I said he was a southpaw. I've seen him on some undercard shows off television. But I think I'm mistaken because he doesn't look like he's switching up.
No, I don't think he's changing at all.
No. There's some grainy photo. Yeah, he said he saw tapes of Ponce de Leon. He said he turned it off and put some Floyd Mayweather on. He couldn't watch it. Ponce de Leon needs to make this a rugged fight. Looks like he used his head a little bit there.
You're gonna stop with the bell! La campana!
With all that experience, Ponce de Leon has one round in the bank as far as studying what the young Broner has to offer.
See how slow he is? Where the counter at? Okay, let's score this counter. You in one hand. I want both hands. You hear me? Okay, let's go. Pick it up. Let's go. Come on.
Okay, mouthpiece is there.
Oh, hold. You got the mouthpiece? You got the mouthpiece?
Get set for the start of round number two. Adrian Broner out of Cincinnati and Daniel Ponce de Leon in the first round. Ponce de Leon threw 46 punches according to CompuBox, 25 more than Broner did. Roy, what would you like to see Broner do here in round number two?
Well, I'd like to see him use a jab more and let his hands go a little bit more like his opponent asked of him. He's clearly the quicker fighter. However, he seems to be a little too cautious here. I know Ponce de Leon has the experience factor, but he does have to let his hands go if he wants to take charge here.
So far, what we've seen from Broner is his supreme level of confidence actually helps him. And this is not a guy who's not going to be throwing back, even though he is moving up in weight, Ponce de Leon. But Broner just fights like a very confident fighter.
He does, but like his corner said, he has to add something behind that one big shot. He's throwing one big counter right now, and most of the time, you won't catch a guy with the first big counter, especially a guy with as much experience as Ponce de Leon has.
During the fighter introductions, you saw Aaron Pryor in the corner of Broner. Pryor was actually one of Broner's first coaches in his early amateur days in Cincinnati. Part of a rich tradition of Cincinnati fighters.
Aaron Pryor, of course, one of the all-time greats, was 32-0 after he knocked out Alexis Arguello for the second time and then had drug problems and came back, wound up losing a fight many years later, but essentially ended his career, his real career as an undefeated fighter, Hall of Famer.
It's one of the better lightweights that I think I ever seen, besides Pernell Whitaker.
Yeah, so good at lightweight that he couldn't get a title shot, had to move up to junior welterweight to get his title shot. Lightweights wouldn't fight him. Cincinnati, like New York City and Washington, D.C. in recent years, has produced a lot of really good fighters and flashy fighters, but has yet to produce a great fighter in the last 10 or so years.
Ponce de Leon doing good work to the body of Broner. That's where he's mad most of his connects. And Roy, Ponce de Leon said to us that he's going to use two or three rounds to feel out Broner. So far, so good for him.
Yeah, so far, so good, because Broner is not really following up with his counterpunches. So now he's letting Ponce de Leon get in the fight. If he lets Ponce de Leon get into the fight and make it an ugly fight, then it may not be a good night for Broner.
Counter right hand from Broner.
Broner's now in pot-shotting mode, where he's just trying to counter off of misses.
Yeah, but his corner asks for more than one shot.
He's not giving it to him.
Ponce de Leon blocked that right hand. End of round number two.
Okay.
Next Saturday night, it's the premiere of Running Rebels of UNLV, an HBO sports documentary about the University of Nevada Las Vegas basketball team, a dominant force in the late 80s and early 90s, whose star-studded teams and colorful coach created headlines both on and off the court. On March 30th, just days before the Final Four, a special episode of Real Sports take stock of the NCAA, examining whether the current system is working or not.
He's definitely a fit too.
There is Aaron Pryor.
I said 32-0. I think it was 36-0 with 32 knockouts. At any rate, he was a monster at junior welterweight, whirlwind style, incredible heart and stamina.
The funniest thing I remember is a guy knocking him down, and he get rolling over, popping up, and the referee had to get him off of the guy to give him a standing eight count.
Let's check in with Harold Letterman, our unofficial ringside score.
All righty, Bob. I've got a 2-0, 20-18. Daniel Ponce de Leon. You know, Bob, I like that left hand to the body. I can't help say that. The kid gets inside, and he digs that left hand hard. He's a real cagey veteran, tough guy to fight, and Adrian Broner's going to have to get a lot more busy doing this fight. Adrian Broner looks good, got good skills, gives you good feints, doesn't throw enough punches. So far, Ponce de Leon doing more damage with that left hand to the body. 2-0, Ponce de Leon.
All right, Harold, well, coming into this round, Broner had only thrown 45 total punches in the first two rounds. Ponce de Leon told us during the fighter meeting, if they're using me as a stepping stone, it's going to be a slippery stone. So far, he's done the good work through the first two-plus rounds.
Yeah, he said it's going to be a very slippery step.
Yeah. You know what separates the really special prospects? What are the fight-wise guys looking for? You're looking for a guy at this stage to start putting his punches together three and four at a time. That combination punching that Broner's not showing.
One counter left from Broner, but not after Ponce de Leon continues to wing that left hand to the body, like right there.
He's making a good shot. Good hook by Broner.
Roy, what do you think stopping him from putting those punches together? He is accurate. He's very fast.
Ponce de Leon getting off first is forcing him to keep his hands at home for defense. That's why you tell a guy to try to get off first. And see that? He makes the other guy keep his hands home for defense. And that's what he's doing to Broner right now.
These left shots to the body just continually land.
Yeah, that was a good left down the middle then, though.
Ponce showing some veteran caginess.
It's what I call the Pacquiao effect. Pacquiao throws so many punches that he makes these guys keep their hands home, and they can't punch back with him. Just like that. You got to catch those punches because you got to respect that.
More of a slapping left from Broner.
And the problem is that Ponce de Leon feels as though he can take these punches now, so he's willing to trade.
Broner might want to left that tape on of Ponce de Leon a little bit longer.
Well, what he might want to do is go to the body a little bit. You know, a young fighter has to learn to go to the body early on an old crafty guy like Ponce de Leon. And Ponce de Leon is going to his body, which should remind him to go to Ponce de Leon's body.
Meanwhile, we got a good little fight going on.
End of three.
Hey, don't make us have no close fight. You know what I'm saying? Don't make it out of no close fight. Put them together. You throw one hook and you ain't coming nothing right to nothing bad. Okay? Let's go. You letting him touch you too much. You know what I'm saying? Quit standing in front of him. You understand? Balance. Move. You understand? Punch on your angles. You hear me? Don't stand up there and war with him. Start back on your jab right now. You hear me?
There's the Daniel Ponce de Leon family, his wife Mira, and Daniel, Geronimo, and Estrella. So far, good three rounds for dad and husband.
Step on his foot and bring that left inside. He's going to fall. Step on his foot.
In the four fights that CompuBox has charted of Adrian Broner, that's the most punches landed against him. Now, he has been in against much inferior competition than a Daniel Ponce de Leon, who made six successful defenses of a junior featherweight championship.
No, usually when a southpaw fights a right-handed fighter, which obviously Broner is, the feet can get tangled accidentally because their lead feet are so close to each other. But here in Ponce de Leon's corner, you hear his corner say in between rounds, step on his foot. They want him to use it as a tactic.
And he's trying to do it too. Just like that.
It'd hold him in place for a shot.
him up.
Hold Broner in place for a shot, not let him step away.
I don't know if I would have changed anything after round three.
But, you know, you do see a veteran here at least trying to follow the instructions of the corner, and a younger fighter not following the instructions of his corner.
And, Roy, it looks like Broner has dropped that right arm a little bit to try to protect from some of those body shots.
No, I don't think that's the case. I think he's just trying to get himself loose and get into the fight, because that's normally the way he fights. However, I think he may have underestimated Ponce de Leon a little bit, because Ponce de Leon is here to fight. And this is what I always try to teach young guys. In boxing, most guys don't get to be champ by accident.
To give people a sense of where Broner is at this moment, Juan Manuel Lopez knocked out Ponce de Leon in one round a couple years ago.
That's when Ponce de Leon lost his title.
But Lopez really beat him on his crisp boxing skills plus athleticism. And here Broner is showing athleticism and some crispness, but not the same degree of skill, I think, that Lopez showed in that fight early.
Well, see, that thing right there, the overhand left, punches like that when you stick a punch out, that's what makes a young guy scared to punch sometimes. And that's why Broner is not throwing no more than one or two punches at a time. He's afraid of the shot that he may get caught with while he's in the middle of throwing his combinations.
And, of course, Lopez is a different kind of fighter, more of a puncher. He's a southpaw, too. Sometimes a first-round knockout happens because a guy's cold, and both these guys are clearly warmed up here.
Good body shot, my brother. If he puts his punches together right here, he'd be better off. But he's still throwing one.
There he puts a couple together.
Gonna stop in the
bell. On the way out.
And see what Broner does to make up for that.
Good scrap.
Put him in the gather now. You hear me? You hear me? Watch him in the mouthpiece. Give me the bucket. All right? Relax, everybody. Relax, relax.
Look.
What I want you to do is, he coming in leaning in every time. Run the combination, okay? Keep working off the champ.
The fight is even, and you got to put them on. A bit more ballsy to get the win. Bring up your guard and attack. Clear attacks.
Here you see Ponce de Leon purposely trying to step on Broner's toe to hold him still so they can land the left hand like his corner asked him to do. That time, Broner slipped out of it and landed a counter right over the top of the left hand.
So we begin round number five in a good little showdown here between Daniel Ponce de Leon and Adrian Broner.
Roy, do you think Bob mentioned maybe it's not such a great idea because Ponce de Leon was doing well before he started to step on his foot? You think it's a good idea or not?
No, I don't think it's a good idea because I think he was doing better before he started trying to reach for the foot. Now he's concentrating more on the foot instead of throwing his hands, and his hands, his output, punch output has slowed down a little bit.
Yeah, it's almost like in that replay we showed you, he was like thinking about trying to get his foot on the other guy's foot. Instead, he had been ripping Broner to the body in the previous round.
Yeah, he's thinking is the point now.
Yep.
And it's not come, the other stuff doesn't come as quick when you have to think.
Wait, well, he can't outthink Broner because Broner is clearly the better boxer. It's just a matter of if Broner feels like boxing or not. So he definitely doesn't want to stay outside and box with Broner. He has to make this an ugly fight in order for him to have a chance. So they should have told him just to keep the pressure on. He can't win a fight out there like that. Broner's too tall and his arms are too long for that. They'll pick him apart just like this all day long.
Much more confident Broner here in round five.
And he did throw some good body shots at the end of that last round that may have taken a little bit of effect on Ponce de Leon.
That right hand is landing very accurately now from Broner.
Come on. much more confident Adrian Broner here in round five.
Now he's fighting at his own pace. If he can fight at his pace, he can do this all night long. When you let a guy fight at his rhythm, then it's very hard to beat him. Now Broner's in his own rhythm, and it's almost impossible for Punxsutawney Miller to do anything with him at this point.
Nice short left hand, and he followed it up with a right hand right to the face, Punxsutawney.
See, Broner has all the tools, the speed, good puncher. So he hasn't really hurt Punxsutawney. Has 16 knockouts in 20 fights and has thrown some good hard shots in this fight. The tools are there.
Yeah, the tools are definitely there.
Turn your back. Turn your back.
A little hot dogging from Broner in his best round of the fight.
And he is prone to hot dog at times.
Well, Adrian Broner with a good round number five. Coming up in our main event, Saul Alvarez. Canelo out of Mexico will be taking on Matthew Hatton. Alvarez fired up to be in the main event.
Tener una pelea en el estelar en Estados Unidos es un gran paso para mí. Y yo sé que ese día, como te digo, ese día voy a salir con la mano en alto, voy a dar una gran exhibición y la gente me va a ver en todo el mundo.
So Alvarez going through his preparations, 35-0 with 26 knockouts, getting set for his 37th bout as a pro. The headliner tonight, huge following in Mexico, wants to make a statement as the headliner on HBO's Boxing After Dark. He'll be squaring off against Matthew Hatton, a 154-pound belt at stake tonight.
Without balance, attack his body with the hook.
Come back with the hook. Everything, come back with it.
And as we begin round number six, we welcome in Harold Letterman.
Okay, Bob, I've got a 28-47, three rounds to two, Daniel Punxsutawney. Bob, I thought Daniel Punxsutawney did enough in the first three rounds to win him with that left hand. But in rounds four and five, Adrian Broner looked terrific. He absolutely took over the fight. But I got to tell you, it's not a fan-friendly style. It's counter and get out. He waits for Punxsutawney to move in to lead. He whacks him with a right hand, and he moves. He gets the hell out of there before Punxsutawney can hit him. And, you know, and that's not a real fan-friendly style at all, that counter and get out of there. And that's how Adrian Broner's winning the fight. Look at that. He'll hit him a counter shot, and he'll move. 3-2, Punxsutawney.
Roy, should Broner be doing a little bit more, as Harold alluded to?
No. At this point in his career, he's smart. He's the guy who's making the step up. Therefore, pushing the issue only can get him hurt. He's smarter to box, stay outside. I know it's not beautiful to us, but however, he needs to be sure to get a win so that he can move up in this big step. If he steps in and something stupid happens to him, then he looks like a total idiot.
But Roy, two things about that. One, as he fights better and better fighters, as you mentioned, some of the success Ponce is having is because he's dictating the tempo at times. And by not leading, Broner's not dictating the tempo. And the other thing is, in the state boxing's in today, you got to inspire people. You got to do more than just win and move on, like what Canelo Alvarez has done here tonight, selling, it looks like, maybe 10,000 tickets. Mm-hmm. And Broner's not going to sell tickets doing this.
No, he's not going to sell tickets doing this now. He's going to take a higher level of competition to make him step his game up even more. But he definitely has the game to step up. It's just that in fighting a southpaw always makes it difficult, and it always usually makes for an ugly fight.
Do you think he has the temperament to eventually lead and make things happen rather than just to sit back and wait to counter?
Oh, most definitely. It's just that because Punxsutawney is a lot slower than him, it's easier for him to counter and just take his time. He knows that eventually he hopes to wear Punxsutawney down. In another fight, in a different fighter, he know he'd have to push the issue. He'd have to work his jab more, and he'd have to do a lot more combination punching against a southpaw that's not smart.
Well, the other thing you have to take into consideration is Punxsutawney went on the belt line. Broner's just 21.
Very young.
Which is why I say this is a smart fight for him at the time, because like that right there, throwing too many punches at one time against a southpaw would get him caught, and he has to be careful of that.
Did work with Devin Alexander through Alexander's camp, getting him ready for Timothy Bradley.
He's a southpaw. And all that said, Roy, you, even you who are defending him in this style, would like to see him lead with the jab more, put more punches together.
I definitely would like to see him lead with the jab more and throw more punches off top. If he lead first, he can get more 1-2-3s off. Like that.
Good lunging left hand to punctuate the end of round number six.
You gotta move your waist. Bend your waist. Come on, son, we gotta be ballsy. We gotta put some guts into it.
Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. How you feel?
Put your hands down.
Go to the body. Why? What we was doing. You know what I'm saying? Okay? All right? Okay, come on, man. So let's go, baby. Come on, listen. Go to the body now, okay? Let's go.
That left hook is coming in. Bring your right hand up. Bring your right hand up. You're doing a good fight. Don't be careless.
We're in Anaheim, California for HBO's Boxing After Dark. Adrian Broner and Daniel Ponce de Leon begin round number seven of the scheduled 10-rounder at 130 pounds. No knockdown so far in the fight. Ponce de Leon had success in the first three rounds with body shots. Broner stabilized things in rounds four and five. Round number six, an interesting round because Daniel Ponce de Leon threw 40 more punches in the round. Although, Broner, according to CompuBox, did land two more.
What you would like to see is Broner make him pay off of those counter punches like that. That's where he'd be more busier at, and he's not being busy. So now when you see that, he is holding back too much. You must make a southpaw pay if you make him miss.
Well, it does seem that Broner's also fighting off the back foot. Even when he's coming forward, he's off the back foot.
And there's nothing wrong with that, but you got to make him pay when you make him miss. That's the purpose for fighting off of the back foot.
Off the back foot. By that we mean his weight is back, even as he's coming forward.
Good shot by Castellano.
That counter left hand. Caught Broner clean. One-two combination from Broner. Good right hand by Broner.
And that was set up off the jab like that. So if he throws first and then counters right away, it's beautiful. But he has to do more of this.
Say this for Broner, too. Sometimes at this stage, a prospect will look fast and make sounds when he throws the punches, but the punches aren't landing very cleanly, very accurately. His are.
Right hand just missed. Ponce de Leon goes back to the body. Broner with a body shot back. Ponce de Leon to the head.
And that's the type of fight that Ponce de Leon wants. He wants an exchange. That's the only way he can win this fight. He won't outbox Broner from the outside. He has to turn it into an ugly fight.
Another one of those counter right hands scored, and Broner connects with a lead right and counter right.
That's three straight right, four straight rights in a row. Good counter by Castellano.
Stop that. End of round seven.
Now I need to dry it out. Breathe now.
Well, right in the middle of your screen, Nonito Donaire, who on Boxing After Dark a couple of weeks ago with an impressive knockout of Fernando Montiel.
Not exactly Sinatra taking pictures at Ali Frazier 1, but it's pretty cool. Still pretty cool.
We had a chance to visit with him before we came on the air, and all fired up, getting ready for his next fight, and going through the pictures, figuring out which ones he needs to delete. He's deleted a lot of his opponents.
He's one of the very best pound-for-pound fighters in the game, Donaire.
And beautiful thing for him is that he and his father and his mother made up after the fight, and I was so delighted to hear that.
Well, there was a lot of acrimony leading up to the fight, the things that were being said, and he talked about it in the meeting, and it's good to hear that they've kind of cleared the air a little bit, Roy.
Yes, it is. Always a blessing.
Round number 8 underway, scheduled for 10. No knockdowns in the fight. Daniel Ponce de Leon, the southpaw, had good success early in the fight with body punches. Broner has stabilized this. He's used his quick hands and counter right hands in the middle rounds.
At the beginning of the fight, I mentioned De Leon's kind of, you know what you're getting. Not a great pressure fighter, not a great boxer. Good puncher, is a tough guy. But you're seeing real craftiness here. Even if it's not classical craft, he is crafty.
Very crafty, because he definitely does not have the hand speed factor here, but he's still landing big punches. He's still hanging in the fight, and he's not getting caught with too many shots.
He's the smaller guy against a larger man who's much quicker. An undefeated fighter with a lot to lose. And given the circumstances, I think he's fighting very well, De Leon.
Certainly he's had his moments in this fight, especially in the early rounds.
No, stop. Come on, Roy. Don't do that.
Roy, what does Daniel Ponce de Leon need to sort of flip the scales here a little bit? Because Broner has sort of seized control of the rhythm of this fight.
Well, he's doing what he needs to do right now. He's putting pressure on Broner, and he's hoping that Broner's starting to tire a little bit, but he got to make it a little bit more pressure, because if he stays outside like he's doing, Broner's going to catch him with big counter punches before the round is over and may possibly steal the round. So you should have the pressure on him right now.
And here's the problem with Broner as I see it at this moment, Roy. When you say it's an ugly fight, it's Ponce de Leon's fight, the crowd is rooting for Ponce de Leon's fight. What Broner is offering is not what the crowd is rooting for. What Broner's offering is, isolated punches, not this. The crowd wants to see some action.
Yep. And if he leads with his jab more, he could do some of this. And he's going to have to do some of this, because this is still a very close fight.
I mean, if he's going to just be better than the guys he fights and not give great action fights, give dominant performances, fine, do that. But this is sort of no man's land. This is neither.
Well, like I said, when you fight a southpaw, it's a little bit different. You can't do it the same, because the moves he's making is not the moves that you practice for in the gym most of the time. I know you say he's sparred against a lot of southpaws.
Not the same.
But every southpaw is different.
And your muscle memory just won't be the same, because you fight so many more right-handed
That's
fighters.
That's exactly right. You grew up fighting right-handers, and grew up right-handers do.
A flurry of action at the end of the round. Well, coming up in our main event, Saul Alvarez squares off against Ricky Hatton's brother, Matthew Hatton. Earlier tonight, Max spoke with Matthew.
Matthew, let's begin with the inevitable stepping out of your brother's shadow question. How's it feel?
Feels good. I've had some difficult moments in my career. I've waited a long time for these kind of nights. These are the nights, as a kid, you dream of. And, what a fantastic experience. We've enjoyed all week, enjoyed the press conference. Didn't enjoy the weigh-in too much, but I feel fantastic tonight. I'm going to go in there, give it everything I've got, enjoy it. I'm coming well with that belt. Big upset.
You made weight. He didn't. We hear that your brother, Ricky, wanted you to pull out of the fight. Why did you decide to go ahead anyway?
Well, I'm a fighter. I've never turned down a fight or a challenge in my life. And despite the weight, I know how well I've prepared for this fight. It's a fight. I was very confident when the fight was first made. I'm even more confident now. And the weight doesn't bother me. I don't think it's going to be an issue. The great Manny Pacquiao is a man who can testify to that. So I believe I'm the better fighter, and I'm going to show that tonight.
Thanks, Matthew.
So that's coming up in our main event against Saul Alvarez. As we begin round number nine, let's welcome in our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Lederman.
Hey, Bob, you know something? If Adrian Broner loses this fight, he can blame it on that eighth round. I mean, here's a guy that won four rounds in a row. He took a 4-3 lead going into the eighth, and in round eight, he did absolutely nothing. You know, Ponce de Leon took it to him. Adrian Broner just backed up, and Ponce de Leon was scored that left hand. Look at this. He's doing it again in round nine. Adrian Broner can't let this fight slip away. Roy Jones was right. It is a close fight, and Broner can't, you know, just give it up. Four rounds apiece, 76-76.
All right, Harold. You know, Roy, that is the interesting aspect of all this when you think about two fighters get tied up.
Hey, that's right. Come on. Let's turn this to the crowd. Let's go.
Referee Ray Corona instructing both. But, Roy, you know, you think about those first three rounds where De Leon hit him with all the body shots and stuff. At the end of the day, you don't want to take any chances, but this is a close fight.
This is a very close fight, and at this point, he does have to take a chance because he's allowed it to become such a close fight. So in the beginning, when he could box and have his way like he was doing for those three rounds in a row, it was beautiful. But then he slacked off, like Harold said. He took the eighth round off, and now he's allowed Ponce de Leon to get back in the fight.
This is the first time in Broner's career that he's fought past the eighth round. Ponce de Leon's done it eight times.
Ponce de Leon has landed some clean, effective shots in this fight. By my estimation, Broner has landed many, many more of the clean, effective shots, particularly to the head in this fight. How they're distributed in various rounds is up to the judges, but in terms of just the kind of overall damage inflicted, it seems to me Broner's done better.
Like that right there. But he's definitely not the busier fighter.
Not a left hand from Ponce de Leon. But Max, all those clean left hands to the body in the early parts of the fight, they count.
They count. It's not that De Leon hasn't had many moments. It just seems to me Broner's had more.
Big hook to the body from Ponce de Leon.
See, Ponce de Leon's willing to gamble and let it all go because he's trying to win this fight.
That's some moments right here.
Yeah, Broner misses with those punches. Ponce de Leon goes to the body. End of nine.
You hear me? You get down on him again. You hear me? Quit bullshit, okay? Quit, you have to take them punches. You hear me?
Get up.
Hey.
You got to put balls on it. Come on. Don't follow him. Don't follow him. Be careful. Don't be careless. You got to win the round and win the fight.
Okay?
Don't touch gloves, gentlemen.
Okay? What you do is, you understand, keep working out the jab. Let him run into it. Let him run into it, then run your combination, okay? Let's go. I know he's wild. He's different. He awkward. But keep using the jab.
Let's go.
As we get set for the start of round 10, according to CompuBox, Ponce de Leon has thrown 211 more punches through the first nine rounds of this 10-round fight.
And this could be a big round in the fight.
Broner has not lost. He's 19-0 with one no decision. 16 knockouts, 21 years of age from Cincinnati. Touted prospect against the former junior featherweight champion, moving up from 126, Daniel Ponce de Leon.
Broner entered the fight supremely confident, and by the look on his face in the corner, it seems like he's finally realizing he's mired in this kind of awkward Ponce de Leon style fight.
Ponce de Leon steps in with a combination. Left hand to the body.
And this is why I don't watch many tapes on fighters, because sometimes a guy on tape appears to be one way, but when you get in front of him, it's a totally different thing. And I think this is what Adrian has run into tonight.
And you can't discount the heart of a former champion, a guy that made six defenses, Roy. It's not something you luck into.
No, it's not. That's one beautiful thing about boxing. You had to beat somebody to become champion.
Usually.
Yeah, usually.
Not all the time. Sometimes.
And his only two losses are to Juan Manuel Lopez and Celestino Caballero.
And being from Mexico, to have that many fights and that many wins, he had to beat somebody.
Yeah. Right hand from Broner.
But you saw Pantaleo answer with four counters. That's the bad part about it.
De Leon has a lot of quality wins in his career.
And he's thrown twice as many punches as Broner, according to CompuBox, in this round alone.
Headbutt.
We got a cut from the headbutt.
Flash of heads, there's the cut.
Over Broner's, Pantaleon's left eye.
Accidental clash of heads, says referee Ray Corona.
Arriba, arriba, homies.
No, Roy, it's funny. Broner, worried about getting countered, doesn't let his hands go, and as a result, he gets hit more than he should.
Exactly, because Pantaleon is using those shots to make him keep his hands at home.
Broner with a right hand at the end of that combination.
Good action this round.
Yeah, but it may be a little too late.
Final 10 seconds of the fight.
You gotta stop for the bell.
Is Broner on the way to his first loss? Fans in Anaheim think so. Side, Daniel Ponce de Leon and Adrian Broner. David Denkin from California. One title fight on his resume. Tony Krebs, also from California. In fact, all three judges are from California. And the Quintana decision over Williams. He scored it for Quintana in their first meeting. And the final judge, Raul Caez Jr. California, 14 title fights at Hopkins' decision over Ornelas. He scored it for Hopkins. Harold, your final card.
Well, Bob, I thought the little guy has got it. 96, 94, six laps to four, Daniel Ponce de Leon. Certainly the crowd thought he would.
Well, he threw 241 more punches in the fight, according to CompuBox. And for Adrian Broner, the 21-year-old, who will not turn 22 until July, as he's staring at his first loss tonight. Pro-Mexican crowd here in Anaheim. They see Saul Alvarez in our main event. Cheered Daniel Ponce de Leon from the moment he came to the ring tonight. So the question is, how did the three judges have it scored? Did Ponce de Leon move up to 130 and beat the prospect Broner? Out of Cincinnati.
Take your time. Take your time.
All right. Michael Buffer has the judges' scorecards.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the Honda Center, Anaheim, California, we go to the scorecards. The winner of this bout will be the new WBO Junior Lightweight Intercontinental Champion. The scorecards. David Denkin scores at 96-94. Raul Caiz Jr., same score, 96-94. Tony Krebs, 91-99. All three for the winner by unanimous decision. The Cincinnati Kid, Adrian, the problem, bro.
No problem. 96-94, it was that kind of fight. 99-91, nine rounds to one. Come on, man.
I mean, did Tony Krebs watch the first three rounds of the fight?
as Ed Lover would say, come on, son.
Let's take a look at the total punches in the fight. 241 more thrown by Daniel Ponce de Leon. Broner landed at a better percentage here tonight. And we take a look at Punch Zone in this fight as Ponce de Leon is hoisted on the shoulders around the ring. And you see to the right, the punches landed to the body on Broner. 81 times Ponce de Leon landed shots there. Broner was able to hit the head of Daniel Ponce de Leon 101 times. But an unpopular unanimous decision victory for Adrian Broner tonight here in Anaheim as he gets his 20th win in a hard